Hello, followers. Welcome to this guide. Let's discover the newest CyberLink PowerDirector 18 and see everything you need to know to start using it. Please visit our YouTube channel and our website to get additional tips, extras, templates, and take part of our exclusive giveaways. CyberLink PowerDirector is one of the best video editing products offering loads of templates, particles, effects, transitions, and amazing titles. It comes in two versions, one for home video editors called Ultra, and another for professional users called Ultimate. In this video, we will show the complete Ultimate version. PowerDirector opens on a dialog window with several options to start your new video project. On top, select its aspect ratio between HD 16:9, the old 4:3, or the new 1:1, most suitable for Instagram and Facebook. At the bottom, choose the way to realize your video. You can compose your slideshow or video project from ready-made templates and music samples with the slideshow creator and auto mode. Whereas if you prefer to have full control and make your video on your own, you can click on storyboard mode or full mode. Both of these open the main interface where just the timeline view changes, going from sequences of media in storyboard mode to professional tracks in full mode. In this video, we will work in full mode only. The main interface is made by four different workspaces listed on top. Capture is used to record from webcams, microphones, or directly from your screen with CyberLink Screen Recorder. Edit is the main place to import, edit media, and create your own video. Produce is where you render and upload your project. And Create Disk is where you create DVD menus, chapters, and subtitles. In this short guide, let's see how to make a great video with Edit and Produce. The Edit workspace is composed by the navigation panel on the left, collecting all the samples and templates available inside PowerDirector. The video preview on the right, and the project timeline at the bottom, where you edit and realize your project. To start working, you have to import all the pictures, videos, and sound files first. You can drag and drop several samples and backgrounds from the Media Room section into the timeline, or simply drag your own files from your computer folders. From this version, you can also import .mov, .mxf, and also 10-bit HDR videos without any conversion. All the files added on the timeline are shown as blocks called clips, with thumbnails and sound waves available. You can check these better by zooming in with your mouse wheel and holding down the control key. All visual clips are collected inside rows called video tracks, and all sound files inside audio tracks. You also have several auxiliary tracks dedicated to effects or text. You can move clips in time or in other tracks by clicking and dragging these. Video frames and audio parts are always moved together, unless you make these independent by right-clicking on these and going to Link, Unlink, Video and Audio. In case clips overlap in time, the ones within the bottom tracks are always shown in front of all the other clips placed on higher tracks. To adjust clips in duration, just drag from their edges. This cuts part of their content. You can also drag while holding down the control key to change the duration by acting on their speed rate, making these slower or faster in time without affecting their content. To cut, copy, and paste a clip, just click on it to select it, and use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V. To split, place the playhead on the interested point and use the split button. To undo any action, use Ctrl and Z. On the left side, you have several options to manage each track. Use the Enable button to hide or mute the content of the interested track and use the lock button to block any modification on its clips inside. To add or remove tracks, just right-click on these. The video preview is very useful to play back and edit the content of each clip. This can work in movie mode and in clip mode. When you play back the project with the player, the preview works in movie mode, showing the timeline content where the red playhead is. PowerDirector has improved HDR video compatibility and GPU hardware acceleration, offering a smoother preview in respect to previous versions. You can also right-click on the preview and adjust its quality up to the 4K Ultra HD resolution. You can also check singular frames by clicking on the timeline and placing the main playhead in time. You can also drag it in time to check the frame sequentially, including audio content. When selecting any clip, the preview switches to clip mode, allowing basic modifications on the clip itself. Click and drag to move, use its nodes to resize and skew, and click from its blue circle to rotate. This is very useful to create the picture-in-picture effect, placing a smaller clip over another. You can customize this effect by double-clicking on the clip in front, using the PIP Designer window to apply corrections, borders, and any shadow, reflection, or motion. In case of pictures, you can also enable the Crop tool to crop it and to show what you like most from it. To apply advanced adjustments on the clip appearance and its colors, just select it and click on Fix Enhance, checking the preview meanwhile. With PowerDirector, you can also add text and titles into your project by using the Title Room section of the navigation panel. Here you find 2D, 3D, and 360-degree text templates you can drag and drop into the timeline directly. These create a text clip with any video or title track showing text over a transparent background. Just make sure not to get text covered by other visual clips placed on lower tracks. To edit the text content and appearance, double-click on the text clip and open the Title Designer window. You can click within text to type in and place, resize, and rotate it as you need on the preview. On the left, adjust the text font size, color, and its distribution, and also apply effects such as borders, shadow, reflection, and backdrop, used to add any background with solid color, gradient, or cropped image. Consider that many of these modifications are applied just on the piece of text selected from the preview. Moreover, if you switch to advanced mode on top, you can also apply effects to introduce or end text, add motion, or other independent objects inside the same text clip, such as other pieces of text, particles, and images you can place and edit. PowerDirector 18 also includes motion graphic titles, which are pieces of text including special motion effects on it. Check them out. Inside your project, you can also import extra objects like particles, shapes, and drawings. From the Particle Room, you can add particle objects to change the way to see all the clips below it. You can also double-click on it to open the Particle Designer and edit the overall particle effect, including its placement, its inclination, and fades. If the particle templates available are insufficient, you can download others for free from the official Director Zone website. You can visit its link inside our video description. Inside Video Overlay Room, you can add several dialogues and geometrical shapes, including pieces of text. Very useful for YouTubers. In case you add shapes, you can use the Shape Designer to customize their appearance, placement, inclination, and text properties. You can also make your own drawings by using the pencil button above the Video Overlay Room panel and clicking and dragging on the preview inside the Paint Designer window. On the left side, you can adjust the brush style, width, and color. Once you click on OK, a new drawing template is made, saving your overall drawing progress through time. You can import as a new clip on the timeline, and you can move and edit it on the preview as other clips. With PowerDirector, you can also apply amazing effects and transitions to your media clips. Inside the Effect Room, you can find all the effects available that you can drop directly onto your clips. You can also use the Effect button to manage and adjust the properties of all the effects applied on the selected clip. Transitions are special effects to introduce or end visual clips, all collected inside the Transition Room. You can apply these to the edges of the clip or between two adjacent clips. The transition is represented with its icon and gets slower as much as it is extended in time. To save your project, go to File and then to Save Project As. .psd files save everything inside the timeline, including properties and options. Whereas if you want to render your project into a final video, just switch to the Produce workspace. On the left side, set the render options, choosing any template for 3D videos, devices such as smartphones and consoles, or ready-to-use options for YouTube, Daily Motion, and Vimeo, including 4K Ultra HD solutions. If you want to define custom settings, you can choose Standard 2D above and set the file format, the resolution, and the frame rate to use at the bottom. On the right, make a final check on the video and set where to save it. Then render it by going to Start. Thanks for watching this video. Visit our YouTube channel for more news, reviews, and tips for CyberLink and other amazing products.